What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. I got a special project we're taking care of today. We're going to be taking out, decommissioning one of these just full of leaks, Blue Ridge Ductless mini split systems, and we're going to put in a brand new, properly sized 18,000 BTU. That's a ton and a half of cooling and heating by ACiQ with their Extreme Plus ductless mini split system. It's gonna be awesome. I'm gonna show you step by step how we do it. Let's go. All right, so we have two 12,000 BTU units. Yep, by Blue Ridge. The back extension. And this is gonna be the one in the front, but one of the first things that I'm gonna notice, and guys in the HVAC world are gonna agree with me, is that the line set that's being used, see how it's all crumbling apart? This line set, right, is not UV rated. So when the sun hits it, it's gonna eat it all up. But most importantly is that this line set historically is plagued with problems, which includes developing leaks in the copper lines, mid-tubing, mid-section, right? From the outside in. And it's rumored to be because of the degradation of the copper. Look, I did pre-loosen this. It's not like I have super duper, but we have a little bit of nothing really. There's nothing there. There's literally nothing there. No refrigerant in the system. It's crazy. So we're going to be taking this unit out, disconnecting the electric, disconnecting the communication line. We're going right here in this room, this rear extension. We got a lot of glass. Let me show you. Look at that, a lot of glass. So 18,000 BTUs, perfect, especially because of the weak and poor insulation of the structure and especially the glass. Here we go. All right, we have the unit removed off the wall mounted bracket. I just wanted to show you what kind of screws they use to screw in the bracket. Insane. Just when you thought you've seen it all, people, they surprise you. Look at that. What's up with that? Oh, I guess if it worked, right? I don't know, would you wanna risk your job with that nonsense? I don't think so. So the outdoor unit is mounted. We originally had it a little bit higher, right, in line with the bottom of the asbestos shingle siding right here. But then when I tried opening the window, it hit the window. So we lowered it down a few inches. I like it there. I want to be elevated off of the ground, at least a couple feet, because right there is the canal. And flooding, you know, if it goes up that high, you know, we got problems. You know what I mean? But we're going to now run some line set. But first, we need to hang the indoor unit. But before I hang the indoor unit, what works for me is that I take some of the electrical communication wire, okay? And if the hole is already drilled, we shove that through the hole, like that. Hopefully it stays there. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna feed this through from the back of the indoor unit to the electrical compartment of the unit, because once it's on the wall, we're not getting that in there easily. So it's easy to do it now, and then we'll run the line set down, across, and to there. All right, we unboxed the indoor unit. A nice cardboard and foam was covering over the top. I took the unit out, and then we have this hardware package with some batteries, flare nuts, and the holder for the remote control, as well as those pads that go onto the indoor filter. Here's our template. You don't normally see that. Let's see if we can get this out of there. So there's our template for this 18,000 BTU unit. we have the option of running the lines and flare connections behind the unit, and that's where they would be, or we go through there, and we're going to go through there. So we're going to line this up inside and see how we line up.
Derek, what are you doing? So go up the ladder. Go up the ladder. Okay, pull the wire. Pull the wire. Pull the, Derek, the drain hose. Remember I said the drain hose needs to be on the bottom. Pull the drain hose too. Derek, the drain hose, the white drain hose. This drain hose, Derek, pull it, it has to be in the bottom. Okay. No, we're good. Stay there.
All right, the unit is on the wall. Just barely makes it, by the way. You're gonna notice that there's a two-wire Molex connector connected to terminals 1 and 2. You're gonna discard that. It does say for test. This is only for test, so you can throw that out. We're gonna wire our communication wire, black, white, red, green. 1, 2, 3, ground. All right. We're gonna start connecting our line set. Looks like it lines up perfectly. Sweet. If that's a flare, I'm Santa Claus. Yeah, I knew this wasn't right. I gotta cut these and flare them. The factory flares suck. All right, at the outdoor unit, we just finished up the line and communication voltage wiring. L1, L2, ground, black, white, red being 1, 2, 3, and of course, ground. And now it's got to do line set, half inch and quarter inch.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is 20 minutes after 10 here in the morning. It looks amazing. Check this out.
And look at it. It's whisper quiet. I love it. I absolutely love it. ACiQ offers a wide range of ductless HVAC equipment, both for heating and cooling for your home or your office. They have options between 9,000 BTU from 115 volt single zone wall mount units to 55,000 five zone multiple zone systems. Quiet, affordable, effective, and it can be customized for your space. It is awesome. And I just can't believe how quiet it is. Absolutely quiet. You're going to get a 12 year warranty, peace of mind, as long as you register it online. And it's simple, intelligent, quiet. You can't go wrong. Let's go inside and see how it's cooling. Now I have it on 60 and set to cool. Oh, it feels so nice and cold, by the way. So our temperature right now is 80 degrees and dropping in this room. It instantly went to 58, 56.
54. Our ambient air. Let's put that up there for a minute. Looks like our ambient return air is going to be right around 82 degrees, probably. Yep.
82.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your time today and watching my installation of the ACiQ Extreme 18,000 BTU mini split heat pump inverter system. I really love their products. They're cost effective. They come with a great warranty. And if you're interested in branding your company with private label availability from ACiQ, you can finally brand your equipment. If you're interested in becoming an ACiQ dealer or learn more about private labeling opportunities, check out the website aciq.com/Mikey Pipes. I'll put a link in the description box down below. Tell them I sent you. They'll give me a pat on the back and you may even get a special discount. And if you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your HVAC contractor, I want you to pick up the phone and give me a call, 516-348-6300. Or save time, book online at typedoc.net. We have offices in New York, South Carolina, and Florida. We're here to serve you. Thank you so much again, ladies and gentlemen. I'll catch you in the next one. Be well, God bless, stay safe.